So you want to go to Missy Buki's house? Now?
Yeah. I think we should verify this in person. Then we can find out if she's really Miss Ibuki's sister, right? You're coming with us, aren't you, Fuko-chan?
No, I think I'll just wait here.
Why wait here? If we meet her, we can settle this quickly. It does seem a little suspicious after all. Why wouldn't she come with us?
Surely she must have had a good reason.
You don't believe it, do you? That she's an apparition of the living or having an out-of-body experience? Or that she's just a spirit and her body's in the hospital? No matter how you look at it, she's a real human being.
That's...
There must be something around here. Like a reason she has to insist she's Fuko Ibuki, or that there's some kind of situation causing her to believe that she's Fuko Ibuki, some agenda we're unaware of.
What sort of situation could it be?
How would I know?
Miss Ibuki! Why, hello there! It's me, Furukawa!
Well, Nagisa, how strange to see you here.
Oh, I remember. You came to buy pastries once.
Hey, Okazaki. I didn't know that you knew Miss Ibuki.
Once, when there was no one in the shop, I gave her a bag of Sanae's pastries.
So I take it that you're Nagisa's boyfriend, then?
No, he isn't. No, honestly, I don't mean that I don't like you, Okazaki. It's just that there must be someone more suitable for you.
Is there someone you're seeing already?
Oh, no. There's no one like that.
There isn't anyone?
Looks like it's your chance, Nagisa.
Forget about what I just said and all that stuff.
Don't you think that Nagisa is cute as a button?
Oh, yes, Miss Ibuki. Congratulations.
Oh, yes, that's right. That's the reason that we came to see you in the first place. You see, Okazaki and I had heard that you're soon to be married to a man named Yusuke. So, we wanted to congratulate you.
But where... Where did you hear about my wedding? And you both even know my fiancé's name? But I don't believe I've told anyone but my dear sister Fuko-chan.
Wait a minute. Your sister Fuko is the only one you've told?
Why, yes. My poor sister who is in a coma. But I thought that you knew about that, Nagisa. That my dear sister is in a comatose state at the hospital?
Yes.
Even if she's asleep, I talk to her about all kinds of things. I told her about my upcoming nuptials, but I haven't told anyone else.
Nagisa and I heard some kind of rumor at school. Someone must have seen you with your boyfriend and then built on the story and spread it around to the students at lunch.
Is that so? Then I understand.
How is your sister doing, by the way?
Strange you should ask. I just went to see her, as a matter of fact. Today her color looked so much better. Actually, I don't know if I'll get married or not. With my sister in that condition, I don't know if I should marry and find happiness or not. I can't decide. I don't know if it's the right thing to do or not.
Oh.
What is happening here? What's going on?
I almost said to that poor woman, she's not in a coma. She's alive and well at school.
You should have said it. I mean, if they were to meet face to face, all would be clear.
But I feel like it's not something you should say out loud without regard for someone's feelings. And Fuko didn't want to either.
Furukawa, are you trying to tell me that you actually believe all of this? That the girl we've been talking to is a ghost or apparition or something? Maybe the marriage that someone was talking about wasn't even her marriage at all. It was someone else's and she overheard it.
It's very strange, but I can't believe that Fuko is lying. I don't know why, but in order to get lots of people to celebrate the wedding, Fuko is making all of those beautiful hand-carved starfish sculptures, and then she's giving them all away to her friends.
Oh, hey, don't cry.
No, I won't cry. But instead of turning to tears, I'm turning to empowerment to help Fuko in her plight.
I have to say that you really get energized when it's for someone else, you know that? Like, what about the drama club, for instance?
Well, that's important, too. But I'm terribly sorry. I just can't ignore Fuko right now. I know you've done so much for me, but it can't be about me right now.
I'll help you.
Huh?
Fuko is on my mind, too. And it's not like I have anything else to do.
Okazaki.
Are you sure it's okay for me to impose on you?
We can't have you sleeping at school anymore now, can we?
Your parents know about Miss Ibuki and her upcoming nuptials, don't they?
Yes, she comes often to buy pastries when they're fresh.
Then I think you should keep your last name a secret. Think of a cover story.
I understand.
In other words, you want us to let her stay here for a while.
Akio and I don't mind at all. But what about your folks, darling?
They're terrible parents. I mean, can you believe they just up and left her and went on a trip? Right?
Tell me, Fuko, what would your family's last name be?
It's Isogai!
Can't believe she picked such an unusual last name.
Fuko Isogai? Why, that would be the name of the family next door, wouldn't it?
No! I can't believe she just saw the nameplate next door and decided that was her last name.
Is she a relative of the neighbors?
No, it's just an unexpected coincidence.
Well, my, it is a strange coincidence, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Even if she used her real name, Ibuki, we could have deceived them.
I'll be indebted to you forever.
Oh, such a polite girl you are.
And it's so very nice to make your acquaintance.
I am not gonna let you get away with that again! Those guys are such perverts! They were peeking in the girls' dorm again!
Looks to me like they just want your attention, Masai. If you would be a little more strict with them, they'll stop doing stupid things, I bet.
I can only hope that's all it'll take to do it.
Hitting would probably have no effect, you know. An armbar would work against them a whole lot better, especially if it's delivered by a woman.
I'm actually opposed to acts of violence, though.
Huh, so you decided to come after all.
Hey there, Peeping Tom.
Hold him. Say, Akko!
My arm hurts. Now I can't take on the student council like I've always wanted to do.
If it's about the drama club, activities have been postponed. We have something else we have to do.
Something else?
Yeah. Taking care of the ghost girl, except I don't believe that's really the case.
Huh? The ghost?
Fuko bothers me, but I'm actually pretty worried about Furukawa, too. I'll be watching over them for the time being while I help. So that's it. Tea?
What are you talking about?
Hello? I'm coming in, all right? Hello?
What is this? There's blood all over this thing!
What are you doing so early in the morning?
Look, it's Okazaki.
Well, indeed it is. Good morning.
Could it be you've all been carving these from last night?
Yes. We're all helping Fuko with her stars.
Excuse me!
Customer.
Get him.
Get who?
The customer.
You can't take advantage of your daughter's friend like that!
He's right, Akio.
Yes, Anai, you tell him.
You can help us carve while you watch the shop.
If you love me that much, you'd want me to stay here with you and send him out!
Nobody said anything like that!
Okay, shall we work?
Yes.
I'll get ready for school.
Lined up like this, the floor looks like the night sky.
Huh? Why do you think that?
Well, they're stars, aren't they? Shining stars.
They're starfish.
They're what?
They're starfish.
So what are you telling me, that all of you have been carving starfish all this time?
Why, yes, of course I am. Why would we be carving something as silly as shining stars? That doesn't make any sense.
Why should you be carving starfish?
Lined up like this, they're all just so cute. These starfish.
Wait a minute, did you hear these were starfish?
No, I thought they were starfish from the beginning.
How could you know that? Do you think starfish are cute too?
They're really cute because Fuko carved them.
Yeah, whatever. Already.
Here you go. Here you go.
You've given out most of them.
Thanks to your family, I'll be able to give out a lot today.
Rather than handing out all these starfish to the students, wouldn't you rather go see your sister?
I really would like to, but I don't know if my voice will reach her.
What do you mean by that?
I can't see her. And honestly, I can't say if my little voice is loud enough to reach her. I think maybe that's why I'm doing all of this.
Fuko? What does your sister call you?
Fuchan.
Then can I call you that too?
Why, yes.
Then can I call you that too?
That would be terrible.
Why so terrible?
Just because!
You...
Miyazawa, are you in there?
Welcome to you. Good to see you both. And who might you be?
Please, please accept this.
Yes?
I'm giving you a starfish.
Thank you. So did you make this all by yourself? Well, you don't say. You're doing this so people will celebrate your sister's marriage.
Yes, and we decided to support her in getting people to come.
I support you too. I want you to do your best.
I will. Thank you very much.
Seems to me you have a very high tolerance level for a girl your age.
Isn't it great that she accepted one, Fuchan?
Yes, it was all thanks to you, Nagisa.
Are you two ignoring me?
Because you are the enemy.
I'm not the enemy.
Then a natural
enemy. That's even worse.
Rather, I want to say the worst natural enemy.
Okazaki, you mustn't harass Fuko.
She gets like that even when Furukawa hugs her.
Fuchan?
Calling her name won't work. When she gets like this, it takes a while. Fujibashi!
What is it?
Can you come over here? When she comes to herself, tell her I'm Okazaki. I've become a girl. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
She's always in a daze, and I think that's dangerous, so I want to caution her. Will you help her out?
Yes. I don't mind at all.
So then when she asks how, just tell her it comes off sometimes. For any other questions, just say, for the time being.
Okay.
Okay, fun team, let's hide and watch.
Will this really help, Fuchan?
Shh.
What were we talking about just now? Huh? Where's Okazaki and Nagisa?
I'm Okazaki. I've become a girl.
Huh?
I said I'm Okazaki. And I have become a girl.
I don't understand. How did you become a girl all of a sudden? This is impossible.
It comes off sometimes.
I didn't know there were people like that in our high school. It couldn't possibly try to up and attach itself to me now, could it?
For the time being.
It could? That's a great shock. Oh, did it attach itself again?
What's with you? What are you talking about?
It was a bad dream after all. That's good. I was afraid that I might just turn into Futaro someday.
Okazaki, you should stop already. There are two Okazakis!
We divide sometimes.
I'm totally shocked!
Hey, Tomoya! I've been watching you! Don't you even try to use my sister for any of your silly pranks!
The same face! There are three
of an idiot are you anyway?
Here you go.
For us?
My, this is a really big star.
Maybe it's actually a starfish.
You knew it was a starfish. Now you are one of my starfish friends.
What? Seriously? This really is a starfish?
Yes. Fuko put all of her heart into carving these wooden starfish.
Really? Wow. Actually, I was only joking about it being a starfish.
I want you to both please hug the starfish. Like this? You look very good. Beautiful!
Don't question your sense.
But the two of them are very pretty, and together they're even more beautiful.
On the outside, maybe, but they're different inside. The elder is a gorilla, and the younger is a hamster. Gah!
Okazaki?
You said something very insulting just now, didn't you?
You really mustn't throw things you've received as a present.
Yeah, Fuko would be hurt if you treated it like that.
Oh, I'm sorry. Forgive me. It just seemed to me like it would be an object with great offensive power.
A flying starfish. It's possible!
You think it's possible?
Everyone seems to be accepting them very graciously.
Yeah, but on one hand, we are picking the people who seem nice to give them to.
Mitsui!
Huh?
I'm Fuko Ibuki. We talked at the school entrance ceremony.
Oh, now that you mention it, you got into an accident, didn't you? Were you discharged from the hospital?
Yes, she was discharged and is repeating her sophomore year. And we have a little request.
I want you to please accept this.
What's this?
It's a present. And if you can attend my sister's wedding, I would be very appreciative.
I'm sorry, but I can't accept it. You're in your first year, so you may not know, but seniors are very busy. All of us have to study for difficult entrance exams. And I just can't participate in anything that will cause lost time. Excuse me.
Oh, poor Fu-chan.
Come on, will you cheer up already?
I'm fine, really.
I'm only saying it because you don't look it.
It can't be helped. I only talked a little with Mitsui at the school entrance ceremony. I'm glad she even remembered my name. I've never attended a class. I only pick up pieces of forgotten wood in art class, and then I carve them in one of the empty classrooms. I wish I had a chance to attend even one class. Just one class.
Okay, then I'll phone Kyo and Sunohara.
Huh? It's not a school day. There seems to be a lot of people around.
It's almost Founders Festival, so they must be preparing for it. Thanks to them, we can get into the school.
Oh, they're here.
Hi there. Good morning to all of you. Okazaki, Furukawa, Fuko.
Good morning, everybody.
Sorry to call all of you out.
I came for Nagisa's sake, and I'd do anything for her, you know?
We thank you so much, Sunohara.
But Tomoya, why do we have to do this?
Believe me, we have our reasons. I'll explain it to you all someday.
Fuko, what's the matter?
I feel kind of nervous today.
Fu-chan, come on in! Our class is almost about to start!
Come over here!
Hurry on over, will ya?
We have all the students. What about the teacher?
That was the problem. I couldn't ask a real teacher after all.
Wait a minute. Is one of us going to be the teacher then?
Well, you're an idiot, so you can't do it.
That's very rude of you.
All right, everyone. You should all take your seats. Class is about to start.
Sanai, how did you...
I heard about it from Nagisa. If you don't mind, why don't you let me be the teacher?
Hey, Tomoya, who is she? Nagisa's sister?
Yeah, something like that. Somebody expects an old-time campus drama.
All right, everyone, please go to your seats.
Sanai acts awfully like a real teacher.
This is our first class, so let's introduce ourselves.
Here! My name is Yohei Sunohara. Sunohara is written with a spring and a field.
What a wonderful name!
Ma'am, Sunohara is an idiot.
Don't say anything unnecessary!
She'll find out soon enough.
It's his energy. It covers his idiocy.
I'm Tomoya Okazaki. At school, I'm just another lazy delinquent.
Doing things at your own pace is best.
I'm Nagisa Furukawa. Tsunohara and Okazaki aren't being serious, they're goofing. But I would like to take this class very seriously.
You sound like the class leader or something to me.
No, I'm not.
Nagisa, why don't you be the class leader?
Oh no, I think it should be Futan. After all, she is the center of this class. We're all here because we care for her.
Yeah, sounds good to me. Fuko, so would you like to do it?
No objections.
Do your best, okay? Class leader?
Well, Nagisa says so.
Well, class leader, if you would please introduce yourself.
I am Ibuki.
No, you're not.
I mean, my name is Fuko Isogai, and I like starfish.
Thank you for sharing. You did well. Fuko? Fuko-chan? The people here are all your classmates and your friends. Let's all get along, okay? You all can get along, can't you?
Yes, ma'am!
Now let's start our class. Class leader?
Call to order! Call to order!
Stand up! Bow! Sit down!
Fuko Ibuki. She's a little different, but she still seems like an ordinary girl. Miss Ibuki at the Founders Festival?
Yes. I thought we could invite Miss Ibuki and have the two meet, so we can get to the bottom of this.
I see. That may be a good idea.
Excuse me, little boy. Please accept this. I want Fu-chan and Miss Ibuki to meet after all.
My sister and I talked about attending the Founders Festival after she entered school.
Isn't that nice, Fu-chan?